আসসালামু আলাইকুম, আই এম ডক্টর শারমিন সুলতানা, অ্যাসোসিয়েট প্রফেসর আদ্দিন সকিনা উইমেন্স মেডিকেল কলেজ। নাও স্টার্ট টুডেজ টপিকস, অ্যাড্রেনোকর্টিকাল হরমোনস। অ্যাকচুয়ালি অ্যাড্রেনাল গ্ল্যান্ড, অ্যানাদার নেম অফ দিস গ্ল্যান্ড ইজ সুপ্রানেডান গ্ল্যান্ড, বিকজ দিস টু গ্ল্যান্ডস রিসাইডস অন দ্য আপার পোল অফ দ্য টু কিডনি, and so their names are suprarenal gland also. Each suprarenal gland weighs about 4 gram. The adrenal gland consists of two portions, adrenal cortex and adrenal medulla. The adrenal medulla consists 20% of the total adrenal mass, and it lies in the central portion of the adrenal gland. Adrenal medulla is functionally related with sympathetic nervous system, and stimulation of this adrenal medulla causes secretion of epinephrine and norepinephrine. Adrenal cortex is divided into three parts. From outward to inward, it has three layers, namely zona glomerulosa, zona fasciculata and zona reticularis. The hormones of the adrenal cortex derived mainly from cholesterol. Like cholesterol, bile acid and vitamin D, these adrenocortical hormones have a central nucleus which is named cyclopentanopyrhydrophenanthrene. Adrenocortical hormones and other steroid hormones like ovarian and testicular hormones, these are C21 and C19 steroids. Now we elaborate these layers one by one. Zona glomerulosa, it constitutes 15% of the adrenal cortex. Zona glomerulosa secrete the hormone mineralocorticoids. Among the mineralocorticoids, aldosterone is most potent mineralocorticoid. This layer of the adrenal gland only has the capability to synthesize aldosterone hormone because of the presence of the enzyme aldosterone synthase in this layer. And the secretion of these cells are regulated mainly by extracellular concentration of angiotensin II and potassium ion. And this layer secretes the hormone glucocorticoids, mainly cortisol. And they also secrete corticosterone and very little amount of estrogen and some androgen. And this cells secretion is controlled by the hypothalamic pituitary axis via adrenocorticotropic hormone. Then we come the layer zona reticularis. From zona reticularis we get the hormone adrenal androgens, and these adrenal androgens are dehydroepiandrosterone and androstenedione. Besides these two adrenal androgens, zona reticularis also secrete very little amount of estrogen and some glucocorticoids. Like zona fasciculata, these layers, the cells of these layers are also controlled by hypothalamic pituitary axis via adrenocorticotropic hormone. Mechanism of action of adrenocortical hormone. As these hormones are derivatives of cholesterol, and we know these cholesterol are lipid soluble substances, so these hormones easily pass through the cell membrane and their nucleus resides in the cytoplasm. After entering into the cytoplasm, these hormones form hormone receptor complex and they enter into the cell nucleus where they combine with DNA or deoxyribonucleic acid and they convert into messenger RNA. And from messenger RNA there is formation of new protein by the ribosomes and we get the desired effect in the target cell. Then we discuss elaborately about the hormones, mineralocorticoid. The name mineralocorticoid came from this idea because it controls the extracellular fluid mineral concentration, mainly sodium and potassium. The mineralocorticoids are aldosterone, then deoxycorticosterone, corticosterone, 9-alpha-fluorocortisol, cortisol and cortisone. Aldosterone is the major mineralocorticoid secreted by the adrenal gland. Out of many mineralocorticoids, aldosterone solely exerts 90% of the mineralocorticoid activity. But cortisol also provides a significant amount of mineralocorticoid activity. Aldosterone's mineralocorticoid activity is 3000 times more than cortisol's mineralocorticoid activity, but the plasma concentration of cortisol is 2000 times more than plasma concentration of aldosterone. Then we come to the function of aldosterone. What are the functions of aldosterone? The most important function of aldosterone is it stimulates the reabsorption of sodium and secretion of potassium ion by the renal tubular cells. Then, number two, it stimulates the sodium and potassium ion transport by the sweat gland, salivary gland, and the intestinal epithelium. Number three, excess aldosterone has effect on extracellular fluid volume and blood pressure measurement. That means it increases extracellular fluid volume and rise of arterial blood pressure, but it has little effect on sodium ion concentration. Excess aldosterone causes hypokalemia and muscle weakness, but too little aldosterone causes hyperkalemia and cardiac toxicity. Like sodium ion and potassium ion, hydrogen ion concentration in the extracellular fluid also influenced by aldosterone secretion. Aldosterone causes or it stimulates the secretion of hydrogen ion by the renal tubules, and this causes mild alkalosis. Why we called aldosterone is a life-saving hormone? Because loss of any adrenocortical hormone activity, or if there is loss of all the adrenocortical hormone activity, then death may occur within 3 days to 2 weeks, unless there is despite mineralocorticoid therapy or there is extensive salt and water therapy by the injectable form. Why it occurs? Because without any mineralocorticoid, the potassium concentration in the extracellular fluid becomes more, and this causes hyperkalemia, which ultimately causes cardiac toxicity. And also, when there is loss of aldosterone or there is no mineralocorticoid, then the concentration of sodium and water in our body is also very low, which ultimately leads to decreased extracellular fluid volume. This decreased extracellular fluid volume ultimately leads to diminished cardiac output, which ultimately leads to a shock-like state, and the sequence is ultimately there is death of the patient. The entire sequence can be prevented by administration of aldosterone or some other mineralocorticoids. Therefore, we called aldosterone is a life-saving hormone. Then what is aldosterone escape? We know that aldosterone causes salt and water retention in our body, but excess aldosterone does not cause excessive salt and water retention. How is it possible? This is possible by a mechanism which is done by our kidney. Excess aldosterone causes extracellular volume increase, and when there is 5 to 15% increase of extracellular fluid volume, this rises the arterial blood pressure 15 to 25 millimeter mercury. This rise of arterial blood pressure leads to excessive water excretion and excessive salt excretion, which we called pressure natriuresis and pressure diuresis. So by these two mechanisms, kidney want to maintain salt and water concentration at a constant level despite there is a high amount of aldosterone. So we call this situation is aldosterone escape. Thank you.